So it turns out Ted Cruz's lies about the Cancun trip were even more brazen than originally thought. He brought along his goddamn college roommate. I'm not lying. This is what Axios is reporting. In explaining his disastrous Cancun trip, Senator Ted Cruz failed to mention his college roommate was along for the visit. Cruz invited David Panton, his longtime friend and former roommate at Princeton and Harvard Law, to join the family getaway. An aide tells Axios the senator extended the invitation only after the Cruz family planned the vacation last Tuesday. He accepted and flew to Mexico, and he stayed while Cruz came back, obviously, because the political disaster was undeniable. And again, this, like so many other pieces of evidence, proves the lie. 100%, right? Like, Ted Cruz originally said, oh, I just went to chaperone my daughters because they wanted to go. But of course, he had a ticket to stay the whole weekend. He had a ticket to stay till Saturday or Sunday and then changed it to come back. And then he tried to say, oh, well, it was my daughters. They wanted to go. I was going to work remotely. But actually, his wife was the one really organizing a trip, trying to invite friends along. He said that he was freezing at home. All they had was their fireplace. But other reporting, including from his wife texts, sort of indicate that they had friends they could stay with. All of these things kept on bringing the story back. So yeah, the reason all of us have been talking about this is because he looks really bad, and because the story's awful, and because he left his constituents freezing to death in Texas. In some cases, people have lost their lives. They've been getting power bills for like $15,000, $16,000, you know, $5,000, $10,000, like all of that. But by continuing to lie, it brings the story back, because all of a sudden there's a roommate. Where the hell did this guy come from? Obviously, that blows the story up, right? And it's no wonder that people are mad, and it's no wonder that people are finding inventive and hilarious ways to protest Ted Cruz. Let me play you a clip. So in case you don't know what that is Ted Cruz's home, the home where he abandoned his dog Snowflake to go on this luxury trip, and that mariachi band is playing outside of his house. You know, a mariachi band representing Mexico, representing his Cancun trip, bringing attention to his evil, to how he abandoned his people in their hour of need, and it is absolutely delicious. And as one of the protesters there notes, Ted Cruz's decision cost lives in Texas. Whether we're talking about international travel potentially spreading COVID, it was unnecessary travel that Ted Cruz and his family undertook. Frankly, he should be quarantining right now, because international travel should be followed by a period of quarantine. Ted Cruz has been ignoring that. Whether it's related to his abandonment of Texas or whether it's related to his irresponsible, unnecessary travel, Ted Cruz has cost people lives. So, this story's not going to go away.